David, on the phone, let me start with you. Laura Silsby came to you, to your orphanage, said she was looking for orphans to take away. Didn't that strike you as odd?
Yes. Laura came to our orphanage very friendly, very polite, asking us, do we need help and do we have any children that are injured and that need help? And well, we answered them. We told her that we had children that had fever and the cold, and they said that they can help by giving us some medicine. And
she also told you that she wanted to take kids into the Dominican Republic, correct?
Well, let me explain it to you. She was asking us, can she help us by taking a few children for us so that they could be raised in an orphanage, in another orphanage.
And what did you tell her about that?
Hello?
Yes, what did you tell her about that, David?
Well, I told her that, I told her that the adoption process is difficult for me to take decisions. And the person that takes decisions is not here.
So you told her that she could not take...
Which is Arthur Lewis, my father.
But you told her that she could not take kids into the Dominican Republic without the permission of the government, correct?
No, I don't know much about that. But I only told her that I can't make those type of decisions. That's
okay.
All I did.
Richard, Laura Silsby learned that you and your wife were in the process of adopting several Haitian kids. It's a process that you'd been in for years. You were doing it completely illegally and inappropriately. And she called your wife apparently three times saying she was in Haiti and would get your kids out of the country. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
What did your wife think of that?
My wife was very surprised and alarmed. She told Laura on each occasion that she called, she said, absolutely not. We do not need any help. She told her that I was in Haiti and please do not do anything with our children.
You were already on the ground in Haiti, already going through the proper channels to get your kids out because you had the proper paperwork. But even after your wife said, do not go to the orphanage, do not try to take our kids, she actually did go to the orphanage to try to look for your kids, right?
Yes, that's correct.
What do you make of that? I mean, what do you think of what she was up to?
To me, it's pretty alarming because we're the legal parents of these children, and we give her explicit instructions not to interfere with them. For her to continue to come and try to find them, to take them to the Dominican, tells me that her intent is not actually the best.
Why do you think she, did your wife point blank say to her, you know, not only don't go to the kids, but this is not the way to do it, this is not legal?
No, she didn't tell her that, but the person that gave Laura our contact information told her explicitly that you cannot just take any child across the border. You have to have the correct permissions to do that from the government. And Laura wanted to make the calls anyway to see if there were ways that she could get children.
So a lot of us are trying to figure out, you know, I mean, everybody's been given the benefit of the doubt to these people, and they seem well-intentioned. They seem, you know, that they're coming from a good place in their heart. Do you believe that? I mean, what do you now make of this? You've had actual interaction. Your wife has had actual interaction with them.
Yeah, for my wife to have three different phone calls and explicitly tell her on each call to not interfere with our children, and for Laura to continue anyway to go to the orphanage to try to find them, to take them, tells me her intentions are not the best. And I guess the best, if I tried to characterize her in the best light possible, I would say her intent was to take children and use them to do fundraising and for support. Maybe it's worse than that, but I wouldn't want to speculate any further.
But do you think that's really maybe what was at the heart of this, that she, for whatever reason, wanted to use these kids or show that she was doing stuff for fundraising?
Yes, because as David may tell you, if you switch back to him, she then hired David when he wouldn't give her any children, and my children were not there. They were with me. She hired David to go from orphanage to orphanage and be her translator and guide, and no one would turn children over to her. And in the end, she was frustrated and crying that none of the responsible adults would give her any children.
Yeah, David suddenly has become sort of reticent to talk to us, so I think I'm just going to stick with you. He has previously said that, yeah, that he was hired as an interpreter by her and told our producers that she would cry. What do you make of that, Richard?
Again, it just shows that her intent really cannot be the best. If the responsible adults are there taking care of the children and providing for them, why would she cry and become frustrated when they don't give them up? I would think she'd be happy to find that there were responsible caregivers that were taking care of the children. But since she wasn't, obviously her intentions couldn't have been the best.
What do you think should happen, I mean, now?
If she had actually taken our children, I think it would actually be a matter for the FBI to prosecute her for abduction or kidnapping. But since she didn't actually get our children, I'm not really sure. I think the Haitian government obviously has strong, compelling evidence in order to keep her. I'm sure that the United States government is doing all it can to smooth things out, and evidently they're not able to do that. So that leads me to believe that the government of Haiti will really deal with what she has actually been able to accomplish.